Hi and welcome to my channel. Today is story time and we're going to be talking about four quick stories that are mostly made up just to help you get straight in your mind some commonly confused jobs. So I've got my blanket as it's a bit chilly here at the moment and I've got my cup of tea. So let's get into it. Lions roaring in the morning sun, searching for a longer day. So firstly, there was a little girl, let's call her Rachel. Now Rachel loved the seaside. She loved everything about it. She loved the seagulls, the crabs, the fish, the rock pools, the coral reefs, the seagrass, the beach, the people on the beach. She just loved observing it and seeing how everything kind of interacted with each other. So when she got older, she started to realize that actually it's the ecosystem that she was interested in, the big picture, how everything kind of interacted with each other, how one thing would affect the other. She grew into a really organized and analytical person that loved kind of drawing different kind of information from here and speaking with different people, and she had excellent written skills. She gained extensive knowledge of environmental processes. She read a lot of books and turned to conservation when she realized some major problems were being caused by synthetic pesticides. One of her books brought these environmental concerns to a wide audience. It was met by fierce opposition by chemical companies. It spurred a change in the national pesticide policy and actually resulted in the banning of a number of pesticides. Okay, next story. There was a young man called Jeff, and Jeff loved the rainforest. He especially loved the reptiles in the rainforest. He quickly realized that people were scared of them, so they didn't want to save them. And he really wanted people to realize how important they were for the rainforest habitat. He was so passionate about protecting these reptiles in the rainforest that he assisted with research to help protect these populations. He also trawled through lots of research to see if there was anything that could be applied to this population. He was really interested in looking at the different characteristics of the species that he was studying, their interactions with each other and other species, their movement dynamics, their reproduction, their diseases. He collected a lot of biological data and samples. He worked with researchers that use modeling software to help estimate population sizes and forecast any changes. He wanted to help develop conservation plans for these species in this habitat and advise on wildlife conservation, make recommendations to policymakers and to the general public. He was a practical, action-orientated person who liked to see tangible results from the research and his time on the job. As a small boy, Archie loved turtles. As he grew up, he got more intrigued by the mystery of them, by their life history, their origins, their genetics, their progression, their behavior. And he eventually turned this into his career. He eventually became the world's authority on turtles. He unraveled mysteries about giant sea turtles in particular, and his research, writings, and conservation efforts actually contributed to saving them from near extinction. He brought attention to the world's declining sea turtle populations due to overexploitation and habitat loss. He loved to influence people, to teach people, to really want to conserve the turtles. And he would do this in a really powerful and motivational way. Now, little Jane. Jane loved watching animals. She once hid in a hen house for 4 hours just to watch a hen lay an egg. She was given a stuffed chimpanzee, and when she was older, she got to spend time with them in real life. She was fascinated by their human-like behaviors. She discovered that they modified sticks to pick out termites to eat them. This tool use fascinated her and she wanted to find out everything about it. So she really delved deeply into this behavior and immersed herself in the chimpanzee population. And it took her years. She was a real thinker, a real intellectual that wanted to spend a large amount of time watching, observing, theorizing. She was an inquisitive person who just wanted to understand more. So Rachel was Rachel Carson and was an ecologist. Jeff is Jeff Corwin and is a wildlife biologist. Archie is Archie Carr and was a zoologist. And Jane, of course,
is Jane Goodall, who is an ethologist. So obviously there are some truths in these stories and some kind of creative licenses just to help explain the different roles a little bit more, to help you maybe see which role you might be suited more to. There's often confusion between these roles, and the way I kind of try and think about it is they're going from very, very wide to very narrow. So if you think of the ecologists, they're looking at really the wide, big picture of ecosystems. They're looking at all the animals, they're looking at the biotic and abiotic, the living and non-living things in that environment, and how everything kind of interplays with each other. Then you go a little bit more narrow to the wildlife biologist, who's more kind of focused on particular kind of species in a particular habitat and how to save those species. And then you go to zoologists that are very, very similar to wildlife biologists, but they're often kind of focusing on one species. And down to ethologists, who are kind of narrow, laser focused on more kind of specific behaviours. Now, if you Google Jane Goodall, you'll see her under lots of kind of different job roles, whether it's ethologist, primatologist, which is a branch of zoology, zoologist, a wildlife biologist. Don't think I've seen her classed as an ecologist. I can understand why people get confused with these job roles, and it is confusing because they're almost part of a bigger job role. So kind of an ethologist is kind of a part of zoology, and a zoologist is part of wildlife biology. I mean, that's the way that I kind of can understand the differences. But her PhD was in ethology, and it is really behaviour that she's focused on. So I would kind of class her as the most famous ethologist. I feel like I've been in this kind of career area for a while, and sometimes I get confused by all the different kind of terms or job roles. So I wanted to do this video to kind of help get it clear in your mind. So I hope this video has helped you understand a little bit more the differences between these job roles, and when you see them written down and you get confused, you'll remember the stories of Rachel, Jeff, Archie and Jane. Thank you so much for spending the time with me today. If you did find any of this useful, then please say thank you the YouTube way by clicking on that like button, and maybe share it with someone who you think also might find it useful. Thank you so much. Bye.